Bill English.
Madam Speaker, my question is to the Minister of Justice and asks, has she been advised of a joint statement from the Chief Electoral Officer and the Chief Executive of the Electoral Commission stating that election advertisements promoted by financial agents must contain a statement setting out the name of the financial agent and the full address of the place where that person usually lives?
Honourable Annette King.
Madam Speaker, yes, it was issued on the 7th of March and can be found on www.elections.org.nz.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Bill English.
Does the Minister believe that government policy intended authorisation statements on election publicity should be visible, clear and legible? If not, why not?
Madam Speaker,
the Honourable Annette King.
Madam Speaker, the Parliament decided what would be in the Electoral Finance Act and every party in this House needs to abide by it.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Bill English.
Has the Minister seen copies of these large billboards the Greens have put up around the country, including this one, that contain an authorisation statement written so small that it can hardly be seen? And does she believe that this conforms with government policy on election advertising?
Madam Speaker,
the Honourable Annette King.
Madam Speaker, it is not my role to decide whether it is appropriate, and I don't intend to give an opinion as to whether it's appropriate. That is up to the Green Party to ensure that they abide with the Electoral Finance Act.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Bill English.
Does the Minister have some sympathy with the Green Party when they are required, like every other party, to conform with the ridiculous requirement that a financial agent has to put their residential address on a billboard? And does she agree that to make this billboard legal, the staff person from the Green Party has to put their residential address on it? And why should they have to do that? And when is she going to admit her policy is stupid, impractical and probably dangerous for the individuals concerned?
Honourable Annette King.
Madam Speaker, this Parliament decided what would be...
Order.
Madam Speaker...
The Honourable Annette King.
Madam Speaker, this Parliament decided what would make up the Electoral Finance Act, and you know, every time this question is asked, the National Party forget that in this House there is still a democracy and the majority of vote wins.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Bill English.
Has the Minister seen the application by the PSA to become a third party, which includes material where the PSA's financial agent, who is a private citizen, has put down the PSA's building address as the correct, as what they believe is the correct address, when in fact Ms Pilot will have to put down her own residential address in an apartment or a suburban street? And every New Zealander who looks at PSA material will know where she lives and be able to track that down and do some of the crazy things that all sorts of people do these days.
The Honourable Annette King.
Madam Speaker, no, I have not, but I do know that many members in this House actually have their name and address in the phone book.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Bill English. Order. The Honourable Bill English.
Why is it government policy that every billboard, every newspaper ad, every TV ad, every T-shirt, every balloon that is put out by any political party or third party campaigner in election year has to contain the home address of an individual New Zealander, the place where their partners and their children live? And why did the government believe that that is the best way to frame our election law, to put individual New Zealanders at risk by identifying their place of residence for everybody?
Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Annette King.
I'm afraid I'm going to sound like a cracked record.
No.
Yes. I'm very, very sorry. but I'm going to sound like a crack record, because this Parliament decided that is what the Act would be.
Order! Order! Supplementary question, the Honourable Bill English.
Will the Minister support an amendment to the legislation which would allow the financial agents of political parties and third parties to put an organisational or corporate address on election publicity, or is the Labor Party going to insist on its ridiculous and vindictive policy that anyone who wants to campaign against them has to have their residential address made public, while the Labor Party deliberately broke this law with the publicity it put out this year?
The Honourable Annette King.
Of course, Mr English is well known for his selective memory, because in this House, no less than 2 weeks ago, my colleague held up the photograph of Mr Key's DVD, which he issued this year at a fair in Auckland, one of his members did. No authorisation, no name, no address. So it's very good to come in here and point the finger at the Labor Party. If the member wants to take this issue seriously instead of throwing insults around, I say to the member, put up an amendment and see what this Parliament thinks, because at the end of the day, it is this Parliament who will decide.
Order. Any further supplementaries? Then question number 6, Barbara Stewart.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. My question is to the Minister of Health
Point of order, Gerry Brownlee.
Madam Speaker, I wonder if we can clarify just what the Minister meant by that. And can we get an indication of whether, if Mr English was to seek leave to introduce a bill amending the Electoral Finance Act, the government would in fact support that leap?
Now, as the member well knows, it's not for the Speaker to try and understand what the questions or the answers are and to give an opinion. Point of order, the Honourable Bill English.
Madam Speaker, I seek leave to introduce an amendment to the Electoral Finance Act which would allow financial agents to include to use a corporate or organisational address as authorising an election advertisement.
Is there any objection? The Honourable Dr Michael Cullen.
It's a member's bill and set down as a member's bill.
No, we've got a clarification here. The Honourable Dr Michael Cullen.
It doesn't matter if it's a member's bill. It's still actually the next member's day. The member's been here long enough to know the standing orders.
So does the member wish to clarify? Sorry, Gerry Brownlee.
The House can do anything.
It can do anything.
Right? So Mr English has responded to Annette King.
We've got a clarification. We don't want to confuse it any further. Leave is sought. Is there any objection? No objection.